Even after all the murdering, even after all your suffering, so you know I love you so. You know I love you so and so. Even after all, I'll let you go on, sir, is the order of the day. And I'll let you believe, sir.
Liquid is so much more to us than just a job. It's more of another child for us. It's the place that we truly love. We wanted it to be the place where we want to come working every day. We wanted it the place to where we can be happy. During our travels, we visited so many dive centers, and we always thought, like, if we'd have a dive center, we would do this differently. And we always started developing the other dive centers, thinking that what should be done better. And while traveling, we started thinking that wouldn't it be awesome to have our own place somewhere that we could run exactly how we would want to run it. So that's how Liquid was kind of born. We are making something that we would like to be part of. When we came to Tofo, we went straight to the Tofo beach and we saw the humpback whales breaching. And I think, as funny as it sounds, we made the decision to stay, because then we really stayed. But it was very small when we started. Like I said, when we took over in October, we had one client in the first month, so we didn't do much of the courses or anything then. But we moved to a bigger premises and bought another boat and slowly started growing.
So I think with regards to Tofo, it's very, very lucky where it's situated. It's situated right in the bottom of the Mozambican Channel. It's kind of in the perfect spot for any sort of megafauna passing through the Mozambican Channel. In this area, a lot of cyclonic and anticyclonic currents passing down, which allows for a frequent upwelling of nutrient water, especially colder upwellings carrying a lot of zooplankton up to the surface, which allows for amazing sightings around here. Absolute sort of mecca for any megafauna in the area, especially filter feeders. Filter feeders, along with our manta rays, our whale sharks, which are kind of our poster boys around here. With regards to the upwelling of nutrient water, it's very, very close to shore as well, so it's very, very easily accessible for divers, free divers, snorkelers. It's a perfect location, and yeah, it's just a very, very biodiverse section of the Mozambican Channel, and it's one of the longest coastlines in Africa, Mozambique, and just the multitude of wildlife you can see around here is spectacular.
What struck me most about the diving here was that there are so many fish. So many fish, the size of fish, the different species of fish. was up there rivaling Indonesia and some of the places that are much more well known. I'm Nadia and I am head of diving operations. I'd ended my last contract in Fiji, and while I was there I watched a documentary called Queen of Mantas, and it was about Andrea Marshall, who is based here in Tofo, and I thought that looks cool. I found myself in Cape Town for a wedding, didn't have anything else to do, packed my dive gear, jumped on a plane, rocked up in Tofo, came to Liquid, and the rest is history. The diving here is fantastic. It is challenging. I've never done the crazy African surf launches that we do here. One of the best things for us to encounter in the oceans are mantas. I love mantas, I do. From the moment I first encountered them to coming here, there's just something about them. They're intelligent, they look you in the eye, they properly interact with you. And when you have a manta giving you the eye underwater, it's like nothing else.
My name is Brian, I'm the general manager. When Liquid was really small, it still had something completely different from all the other dive centers, and that was offering a family environment where you are almost instantly included as soon as you walk through the door. Satu and Yari have had amazing ideas to move the business forward, and they've always wanted to do something new here. So the first thing that they did, even before they moved into the new place here, was start IDCs. A lot of people said that it would be impossible to do an instructor development course in Tofo. And they almost laughed at Yari and Satu.
There is no active IDC center in Mozambique. Some of the dive centers, they've done a few previously, but we wanted to really push it through and make it happen. We do three IDCs at the moment, and let's see if it keeps on growing as it has been. Maybe we go with four, and yeah, who knows, maybe even more in the future. It is getting more and more popular. The word of mouth is going around, and we will get the inquiries quite a lot. We get Tofo kind of on the map, and people get more information about Tofo and the possibilities to do the IDC here, because it's a fairly unknown area. After the IDC, you may stay with us for a short period of time and practice your teaching skills and get your own way to do your teaching. You can, if you get lucky, like one of the IE groups, they got humpback whales on the IE with the examiner underwater, so that's something special, very special.
During a humpback season, it is spectacular in the way that you can just standing here at Liquid and you can see two or three pods of whales just having fun in the bay, or you can be out on a boat kind of tracking them down as well. More notably also, you can also see them and hear them while scuba diving. It's magical having sort of the sound of whales during your whole dive, just as a nice kind of backdrop. And in peak season, you're kind of almost guaranteed every boat ride to spot a pod of whales. We have had sort of a number of people inquiring about free diving with the whales, spending time in the water with them, learning. So we have incorporated this new program called the Whale Week, starting from July. It's going to be a week kind of course where we're going to speak through about just basic fundamentals of free diving. So achieving your open water free diver, and then trying to do a few sessions in the water with these animals for sort of research purposes, and also just the slight chance of spending time with a 50-ton animal in the water is absolutely amazing, and it gets anybody excited and in a safe and controlled environment.
Liquid has drawn people into Tofo not just for diving but for extracurricular activities. So you've got kayaking, estuary, we take people on cultural tours, we get people involved in the community. We've always been heavily focused on a green ethos. One example is that we're a vegetarian restaurant. Now, not all of us are vegetarian here. However, it's a concept of reducitarian. So if you can get 12 people to eat breakfast and lunch that doesn't consist of meat, consists of local ingredients that's sourced from inyamban and tofu, you're automatically making a difference to the environment. The green star rating that we got from Paddy is also to do with us pushing the project aware specialties, and we try and teach them as much as possible. The documentary night was actually a dream of Satu's, and she chose me to instigate it. So we started thinking about how we can educate people in a kind of fun, inviting environment. Yeah, just try and mix things up a little bit.
So my name is Joey. I tried to find a job in dive centers. The first thing, I didn't know anything about the dive center, but the first thing was a compressor. They taught me how to use compressor. That was my first job. No, they taught me how to drive a tractor, to launch the board with the tractor. And then I did that job. I finished it. I did my driving lesson. And then I tried to learn other thing again. In the first day, I did my open water in the pool. Yeah, I feel like, you know, it's difficult for me, you know, panicking, you know. And second day, I did better than the first day. The first day, yeah, I was good in the pool. And they took me to clownfish. I didn't go to see fish. Just I saw, you know, the coral. And something like a flowers there, you know? And for me, it was interesting for those things. Then I done my open water. I stayed like a month. I did my advanced to see in deeper. I like it because I saw manta, I saw turtle there, I saw sharks. Yeah, on the first day, so I was lucky on that day. And then I was happy on that day because manta is beautiful down there. Sharks also is beautiful down there, you know. So it's nice, and then they're friendly. They don't bite anyone. So they're friendly. If I take land to estuary, so that I guarantee that you see seahorses. It's very, very nice. So it's a tiny one. It's difficult to find them, but. I'm a little bit professional to find that the seahorses. But it's not only seahorses. We find the sea cucumber also, crabs, pipefish. We see sea urchins there, starfish. So different stuff there. I do kayak tours. I used to take clients to Ilha dos Porcos to show them a school, church, and hospital. And also I showed them a different culture from that island. And also I used to introduce a community and chief. It's 996 people they're living there. And then that island is 3 kilometers square. I do kayak tours on mangrove to see a kingfisher, flamingos, and other different kind of birds. So I see that liquid is changing my life slowly. My life is getting better because now I'm almost finished my dive master, and my boy said he had to. You and Alberto, you guys have to do IDC. So, yeah, so that's, I'm happy for that, no?
In the beginning, I'm sure most people in Tofo thought we're crazy and it's not gonna happen. And so many people told us that you can't do this and you can't do that. And now we've shown to many people that actually you can do anything you really put your heart into. And we are very, very proud. The moments that when we have lots of people watching the documentary, the conservation documentary, and people asking questions, and I can just observe. It's great. We saw the whales, and I think we decided to stay when we saw the whales so close by. But then we did do a couple of dives before we actually bought the dive center, and we had it all there. I mean, there is no rubbish. It's beautiful. We had mantas, we had whale sharks, we had small eye stingray on the first dives, and we were loving it. And it's also because it's not easy. There is something more, and people have come together because of something really important. And we've created that. That's great. That is a good feeling, yeah. One of the things that I love here is that nothing is ever easy, but when you actually get it done, it feels so damn good.